Hello friends, this is Dr. Deepak. We are discussing in this presentation regarding tablet manufacturing defects. Tablet features. What are various features of tablet which make them unique dosage form? Tablets are solid dosage form, playing key role often in the first place among all our dosage forms. They are having more stability, more reliability, easy to use, administered, and packaging suitable to all type of control dosage forms, prefers rough handling, maximum output in short period of time. An ideal tablet should be elegant looking and free from any visual defects or functional defects. Visual defects are those defects which are radially observed from visual observation or physical observation of tablet, like change in color or broken edges or layer tablets. Majority of visual defects are due to inadequate fines or inadequate moisture in the granules ready for compression, or due to faulty machine setting. Functional defects are due to faulty formulation, which results in tablet failing to qualify quality control test. So, visual defects have nothing to do with the formula. Formulation is correct, but due to some faulty machine setting or processing conditions, the tablet physical appearance itself shows that tablet has poor visual quality. But the functional defects, formulation itself is faulty, and it lead to the failing of quality control test. Tablet processing problems can be due to the problem in the formulation or in the compression equipment or both of them. Thus, we can classify the problems into following type. The defects related to tableting process, capping, lamination and cracking. The defects related to excipients, chipping, sticking, peaking, binding. The defects related to machine, double impression. In following section, we will discuss all these defects in detail. Sources of tablet defects. Moisture. It may be low moisture or high moisture which can cause the defect. Improper drying, high drying or low drying, both can cause tablet defects. High speed of machine, tool setting problem, improper use of binders, incorrect lubrication, lack of proper lubricant, air interaction or air entrapment, abnormal ratio of excipients, temperature adjustment, size, shape, improper training and lack of knowledge. All these sources are key players in causing tablet defects. Various type of tablet defects can be enlisted as weight variation, mottling, peaking, sticking, capping, lamination, chipped edges, soft tablets, print defects, black spot or hairs, protracted disintegration. In following section, we will discuss one by one. These all defects. First defect is weight variation. Weight variation is a defect when tablets in the batch fail to pass uniformity of weight test. It is very important that tablet weight should be within specified limit as per official test. Tablet weight is indicator of the drug content or content uniformity. So weight, if the weight is uniform, it is considered that the tablet contents are uniform, drug content are uniform, and tablet is having good quality, good content uniformity. What causes weight variation? Non-uniform mixing of all excipient causes weight variation. Ununiform size of granules, which lead to segregation, which may affect the weight of tablets. Improper blending of granules causes weight variation. Fines will give more weight than larger granules. Improper lubricant gliadin selection or insufficient lubricant gliadin concentration affects flow property or flow of the granules from hopper to the compression station, leading to the weight variation. High speed of tabulating machine can also cause the weight variation. Next defect is mottling. Mottling is the term used to describe an unequal distribution of color on a tablet, with high or dark spot standing out in an otherwise uniform surface. One cause of mottling may be color drug, whose color differs from the color of excipients used in the granulation of a tablet. So mottling, in simplest term, is ununiformity of tablet colors. It may be different shades of color, or it may be spots of different color in color tablet, or it may be black spots appearing on a white tablet. So any ununiformity of color on tablet is called as mottling. The causes and remedies of mottling are: a color drug used along with colorless or white colored excipient can cause mottling. So using appropriate complementary coloring agent in this formulation can reduce the mottling or can avoid the mottling. Dye migrates to the surface of the granules while drying. This is one of the major cause of mottling. Changing the solvent system can reduce this problem, or changing the binder can reduce the problem. Reducing drying temperature and using small particle size can also avoid mottling in this case. In this case, actually what happens, when we dry the granules, the drug dissolved in the solvent come along with the solvent on the surface of the granules while drying. And therefore, the surface has more color as compared to the core. And when we compress this tablet, the tablet has ununiformity of color. So if we dry slowly, the migration will be reduced. Or if we change the solvent, this problem can be solved. Improperly mixed dye, especially during direct compression, can also cause mottling. Mixing properly and reducing size of it, of a large size, to prevent segregation. So improper mixing in cases of direct compression is one of the major cause of mottling. So in these cases, the mixing time, mixing speed we have to change, or mixing process we have to change. And along with that, if the particle size of granules or the coloring agent is high, we have to use fine granules or coloring agent. Improper mixing of colored binder solution. In cases of wet granulation, if the colored solution is used and it is not properly mixed, it can cause mottling. Adding dry color additives during powder blending step, then adding fine powdered adhesive such as acacia and tragacan and mixing well, and finally adding granulating liquid, can reduce mottling in this case. So when the color solution is used for granulating the blend and mixing is not done properly, there is chances of mottling. So in these cases, we have to use dry powder color or dry color during the blending itself, then adding binder, again mixing very properly, and then adding granulating fluid and mixing properly can reduce the mottling. Next defect is peaking. Peaking is the term used when small amount of material from a tablet is removed from the tablet surface by punch face. The problem is more prevalent on the upper punch faces than on the lower punch. The causes and remedies of peaking related to machine. Rough or scratched punch faces can cause picking. Actually, in picking, some part of tablet is picked up by the punch after compression when it is removed from the surface of the tablet. So polishing punch faces to high luster, plating the punch faces with chromium to produce a smooth and non-adherent face of punch can reduce the picking. Bevels or dividing lines too deep. In some cases, even the embossing or bevels or dividing lines are very deep, which can cause picking by the punches. Designing lettering as large as possible, reducing the depth and sharpness of embossing can reduce the picking. Pressure applied is not enough to. Therefore, two soft tablets are produced which are easy to pick by the punches. So, increasing the pressure to optimum to get good hardness of tablet can reduce picking. The causes and remedies of picking related to formulation. Previously, the causes and remedies were related to machine. Causes related to formulation. Excessive moisture in the granules can cause picking. So drying the granules properly with determining optimum moisture can reduce the picking. Too little or improper lubrication can cause mottling. The increasing lubrication using colloidal silica as polishing agent so that material does not cling to the punch, or changing the lubricant can reduce the picking. Low melting point substances may soften from the heat of compression and lead to picking. If any formulation contains low melting point excipients or material that can melt during compression compression process due to the heat of the compression and which may lead to the mottling. Example, PEG or other waxy materials, low melting point waxy materials can lead to the picking. In this case, adding high melting point materials using high melting point lubricants or carrying out compression at low temperature can reduce the picking. Low melting point medicament in high concentration can also cause picking. In these cases, refrigerating granules and cooling the entire tablet press and carry out tableting process at low temperature can reduce the picking. Too warm granules when compression. Sometimes, due to the time constraint, we carry on compression before the granules are cooled properly after drying. So in these cases also, chances of picking are there. So the granules should be sufficiently cooled before compression, and the compression process should be carried out at room temperature to reduce the picking. Too much amount of binder can also cause picking. So reducing the amount of binder to optimum concentration can reduce the picking. Next defect is sticking. Sticking refers to the tablet material adhering to the die wall. Filming is a slow form of sticking and is largely due to excessive moisture in the granules. So, in cases of picking, the tablet material was actually getting adhered to the punches. But in sticking, the tableted material get adhered to the die wall. Sometimes the process of sticking, very thin layer of granulating material is formed on the die, which is called as filming, since the sticking is very finely film like appearance. The causes of remedies related to machine for sticking are concavity too deep for granulation, reduce the concavity of punches or dies to optimum. Too little pressure, increasing the pressure. Compression speed too fast, reducing the speed to optimum can reduce the sticking. Causes and remedies of sticking related to formulation. Granules not dried properly can cause sticking. Drying the granules properly, adjusting moisture analysis to determine limits, and keeping moisture content optimum at every compression process or compression cycle can reduce the sticking. Too little or improper lubrication, increasing the lubrication quantity or changing the lubricant can solve the problem. Too much binder can cause sticking. Reducing the amount of binder or using a different type of binder can solve the problem. Hygroscopic granular material can lead to the sticking. So modifying granulation and compressing under controlled humidity can reduce the sticking problem. Oily or waxy materials, modify mixing process, adding an adsorbent and carrying out compression at low temperature can reduce the sticking. Too soft or weak granules, optimize the amount of binder and granulation technique can solve the sticking problem. Our next problem is capping. Capping is term used when the upper or lower segment of tablet separates horizontally, either partially or completely, from the main body of a tablet and comes out of as a cap during ejection from the tablet press or during subsequent handling. Capping is usually due to the air entrapment in the compact during compression and subsequent expansion of tablet or ejection of tablet from the die. So capping is a defect in which tablet after compression separates into two parts. Upper part is removed or separated or appears to be separated. Therefore, this process is called as capping. The causes and remedies of capping related to machine are poorly finished dies, polish the dies properly, investigate other steel or other materials for dies. If the dies are faulty, change the dies or finish them properly or use high quality dies. Deep concave punches or beveled edges of punches. Use flat punches because beveled edges can get top of the tablet picked up, resulting into capping. Lower punches remain below the face of the die during ejection. In some cases, faulty setting leads to the lower punch not coming properly at the surface of the die while ejection of tablet, leading to the friction of tablet and capping. Incorrect adjustment of sweep of tablet blade. So in some machines, the tablet sweep up blade, which removes tablet from the vicinity of die after ejection, is not properly set. Therefore, it cuts the tablet and leads to the capping. High turret speed can also cause the capping. So making turret speed or machine speed properly or optimum can reduce this problem of capping. These all were related to the machine factors which cause capping. The cause and remedies of capping related to formulation. Causes are large amount of fines in the granulation can cause capping. So removing some of granules or all of the fines through 100 to 200 mesh screen can solve this problem. Too dry or very low moisture content leading to loss of proper binding action can cause capping. Moisturing the granules suitably to optimum level Adding hygroscopic substances in these cases, example sorbitol or methyl cellulose or PEG, can solve the problem. Not thoroughly dried granules can also cause capping. Drying the granules properly to optimum level can solve the problem. Insufficient amount of binder or improper binder can cause the problem of capping. Increasing the amount of binder, adding dry binder such as pre-gelatinized starch, gum acacia, powder sorbitol, PVP, hydrophilic silica or powder sugar can solve this problem. Insufficient or improper lubricant can also cause capping. Increasing the amount of lubricant or changing the type of lubricant can solve the problem. Granules are too cold during compression can also cause capping. Compression of tablet at room temperature can solve the problem. This is generally recommended to until mentioned, the compression should be carried out at room temperature to solve or to reduce many of the defects in the tablet processing. Next defect is lamination. Lamination is the defect in which the separation of tablet takes place into two or more distinct horizontal layers, or tablet after compression forms different visible layers, which is called as a lamination. Air entrapment during compression and subsequent release on ejection can cause the lamination. The condition is exaggerated by high speed of turret. If the air is getting entrapped into the tablet after compression, and when the tablet is ejected, the air gets released, which lead to the lamination, resulting in the layered type of a tablet. So this process is more aggregated in cases of high speed operation or processing. Example, causes by machine or causes by formulation, both can cause the lamination. Faulty formulation or faulty processing, both can cause the lamination. So reasons for lamination with related to formulation are: only waxy materials, oily or waxy materials are present in the granules. Modifying the mixing process, adding adsorbent or absorbent can reduce the lamination problem. Too much of hydrophilic lubricant present in the mix or blend can cause lamination. Example, magnesium stearate. Using less amount of lubricant or changing the type of lubricant or mixing different type of lubricant can solve this problem. The cause of lamination related to machine and their remedies. Rapid relaxation of the peripheral region of a tablet on ejection from the die can cause lamination. Using tapered dies, that is, the upper part of die is slightly wider as compared to the core of the die, are called as tapered die. This can solve the problem. Generally, the outward tapering of die is about 3 to 5 degree. Rapid decompression. Using pre-compression step and reducing the speed of turret and final compression can reduce the problem of lamination. Chipping. Chipping is defined as the breaking of tablet edges while the tablet leaves the press or during subsequent handling and coating operation. Reason for chipping is incorrect machine setting, especially misset ejection takeoff. So in chipping, generally the edges of tablets are broken down after compression or after ejection from the die wall, leading to the broken type of tablets from the edges. The reasons for chipping related to formulation are sticking on punch faces, drying the granules properly or increasing the lubrication can solve this problem. Using true dry granules for compression can also cause chipping. Moistening the granules to plasticize or adding hygroscopic material can lead to the solving of chipping problem in these cases. Too much binding causes chipping at bottom. Optimizing binder concentration or changing the binder or using dry binders can solve this problem. Chipping reasons or causes related to machine are groove of die worn at compression point, polishing to open end, reversing the die or replacing the die. Due to continuous use, sometimes the place of a die where tablet is compressed gets some groove or it gets somewhat cavity type structure which can lead to the chipping. So polishing the die properly or changing the die can solve this problem. Barrel die in which the center of the die is wider than the ends can also cause chipping. Polishing the die and making it cylindrical and smooth can solve the problem. Edge of punch face turned inside or inward can also cause chipping. So polishing the punch edges properly and maintaining them properly can solve the problem. Concavity to dip to compress properly in the punches. So reducing the concavity of punch faces or using flat punches can solve the problem. Next is cracking. When small fine cracks observed on the upper and lower central surface of tablets are very rarely in the sidewall are referred as cracks, and the process is defined as cracking. So sometimes fine cracks are observed generally in the center of the tablet after compression and very rarely at the side edges of the tablet. This is called as cracking. The causes of cracking related to formulation are large size of granules are used for compression that causes cracking. So reducing the granule size and adding adequate amount of fines can solve the problem. Too dry granules can also cause cracking. So moistening the granules or adding hygroscopic material or proper amount of binder can solve the problem. Tablets expand after compression leading to cracking. Improving granulation and adding dry binders can solve the problem. Granulations are too cold during compression. This also can cause the problem. Therefore, the compression should be carried out at room temperature to avoid cracking. Related to machine, which the problems or the factors related to machine which causes cracking are: tablet expands on ejection due to air entrapment. Using tapered die or pre-compression process, it can solve the problem. Deep concavities cause cracking while removing the tablet. So using special take-up and or using plain punches can solve the problem. Soft tablets. The tablets are susceptible to hydrolysis and develop soft nature. The strength of bond is weakened across granules, forming very, very soft tablets. This is caused by improper storage of the granules or lack of drying of granules, or using very low compression force can cause soft tablets. This can be controlled by properly dried granules used for compression or properly drying up granules to optimum moisture level can solve this problem. Granules should be stored at dry condition, making them completely free from moisture, especially when moisture absorbing material is present in the granules, and application of high compression force can solve the soft tablet problem and can produce very good hard tablets. Next defect is double impression. Double impression is involved in only those cases where the punches have a monogram or other engraving on them. At the moment of compression, the tablet receives the imprint of the punch. But in some machines, the lower punch freely drops and travels uncontrolled for short distance before riding and ejecting to push the tablet in the ejection can. So during the ejection of tablet from the die, in some cases the lower punch drops then again rises and ejects the tablet. And during this process, it may rotate slightly. And again, when it comes in contact with the tablet, the engraving, the embossing can be again printed on the tablet, resulting into double impression or double embossing of the symbol or that name or cavity, resulting in double impression, double compression. So causes are periodization of either upper punch or lower punch during ejection of a tablet can it generally cause the double impression. So remedies are using keying in tooling, that is insert a key alongside the punch so that it fits the punch and prevents punch rotation. So using key in the machine, in the die or in the punch fitting, preventing the free rotation or free falling of the punches can solve this problem. Newer presses have anti-turning devices which prevent punch rotation. The new tableting presses with modified technology prevent this problem. So if our machines are old, either use key or replace the machine with new technological advanced machines can solve the problem. This is all about defects in tablet. Thank you. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel Khubraz Academy. Our channel specifically is for pharmacy students, and we will be having more such kind of videos specifically related to pharmaceutics and pharmacology in near future, which will be very helpful for your GPAT and your general examination. Thank you.